It's here, the LG CordZero. Does it suck worse than your first job at McDonald's? Let's find out.
Turn it up until they all hear the beat.
Hey guys, it's your boy Jason Keyz here, and I am super excited. I got a new vacuum cleaner. I know it's not something like normal people are excited about.
No.
But I love tech. I love keeping my house clean. In fact, I don't have my old vacuum cleaner. It disappeared, and I needed a new vacuum cleaner. So I started researching. You know, there's amazing products by Shark, which I did order one, and we're gonna review it because I do wanna compare it to this. So look for the links below. But this is the first one that showed up. That one's still in the mail somewhere. I blame UPS and FedEx for that. This guy's here, it's the LG CordZero, and I was literally caught in the spectrum of, do I get something affordable for $100, $200 by Bissell or Shark, which do make amazing products, and or do I go something like all the way to Dyson and spend like $700, $800? And this falls in that premium line. This is very close to a Dyson in price range. If you haven't traveled internationally or lived internationally where LG is an extremely popular brand with home appliances and everything, it's not as popular in the US, but man, they do make great products. And so I stumbled upon this one. Pricing was quite right. It's definitely in the premium range next to a Dyson, but the design, it resembles it. It's got some cool features that I preferred better, including the removable battery pack, and it comes with two batteries. My house here is about 80% hardwood floor and about 20% carpet, or maybe 25% carpet. So I wanted something that has a brush roller that's designed for hardwood floors. Now, we've also recently tested the Shack. I keep calling it Shack. Shack, if you're watching, you were horrible at free throws, but call me because I keep mentioning your name and I want some royalty money for advertising for you. But anyways, the Shark Vac Mop is something we recently tested, so look for the link in the comments below. That's great if you want it around the kitchen area or around the dining area where your kids or yourself, if you're a sloppy pig, might be dropping food on the floor and you wanna vacuum it up and then mop immediately after. This is great if you're just doing like living room areas, hallways, staircases in my house, and even carpet when you're in the, you know, the bedrooms and stuff like that. So it comes with two batteries. It's got an extendable nozzle. It has this really cool mount that holds the attachments and charges it. It has a roller that's specifically designed for hardwood floors, which I'm super looking forward to using. It's basically like a soft roller that vacuums, and it's got a standard carpet brush head. So without further ado, let's unbox this thing, let's charge it up, let's test it, and then maybe I can finally go back to keeping my carpets clean and my house clean because I now have a new vacuum cleaner. Anyways, let's put it to work. Oh, it's heavy. All right, so let's unbox it first here real quick. Get the knife out here, get that plastic out of the way, sticker, and there we go. All right, so here it is. As you open up the box here, the LG CordZero, extremely powerful cordless stick vacuum. Little cover here, get rid of that. It's got the CordZero A9 maintenance guide. It tells you how to take care of it. What's super cool about this, I love this, in the fact that all the filtration components are machine washable. I hate having a vacuum cleaner where you need to buy a $50 filter or something of that nature later on. So this is great. This is really funny. It comes with the little suction cups. You can stick it on your refrigerator or your forehead or your windshield when you're driving around. But actually not a bad idea to maybe stick in the laundry room or the pantry area, wherever you might be keeping your vacuum cleaner, because it really walks you through how to keep it maintained and keep it sucking good for the rest of its useful life, which is really important because when a vacuum cleaner loses suction, it's nothing worse. In this packet here, we have the mounting screws, double-sided tape, some anchors, and like a mounting bracket to mount the charging base to the wall. So I'm gonna set that aside because that's super important and I definitely wanna have this mounted somewhere either in the laundry room or in the garage where it's gonna be easy to access. In this next box, we have, looks like one of the extension mounts. We'll put this together in a few minutes, so I'm not exactly sure. Here is a filter, one of the filters that it comes with. Let's go ahead and open that up, because like I said, we're gonna be assembling this thing anyways. This is yellow. It literally shows that it's washable with about 50 pictures of a faucet. That's neat, so set that aside here. Let's keep going. Here is the battery pack. You get two of them. Bunch of caution labels. And let's see here. This is a 48 watt hour battery. So that's great. Here we go, 2.4 amp hours. And weighs about a pound, I'd have to guess. You get two of them, that's good. So we'll set that over here. Here is your power adapter, which I don't think you need to actually plug into the vacuum cleaner. This plugs into the charging base. And here we go. Let's get that out of there. Again, if you're watching this and you're in the United States, you're gonna get a standard two-prong, no ground on this one, because it's low voltage outlet brick here, and it's gonna plug into the base. We'll move along to the next part. Let's see what this is. Here we go. This is another further component, another part of the charging base assembly. You can see you've got what is likely a positive and negative kind of spring-loaded charger. So when you stick the camera in there, you stick the vacuum cleaner in there. May I help you? Hello, Lola. Lola's on set today. Do you want me to vacuum all your hair off the floor, off the walls, off the sofa? This vacuum cleaner you should be paying for, because you are a hairy beast, and I think this will be helpful. Anyways, Lola's on set, and Lola's now offset. There we go. All right, so back to what will be part of the base. Like I said, there is a positive and negative. It's kind of a spring-loaded thing, so when the vacuum attaches here, those are gonna be the contact points for wirelessly, if you will, or basically cord-free charging of it. So once this is plugged in here on the back, you'll be able to not have to like reach for a cable or a cord and plug it in. You just mount this back when you're not using it and it'll charge itself. So that's great. Continuing along here, let's go. This is probably, this is just part of the actual vacuum assembly. This is probably the extendable handle on it. So you can see if you're really short, you keep it short, or you're having one of your kids help. And if you're taller, you can extend it out. So it is adjustable in size. And once we put it together, we will test that out. What else is in the box? Okay, this is neat. This seems to be the actual vacuum head just by the shape that I'm seeing here. And there it is. Now I'll tell you, without the battery pack in here, this is super light. This is probably maybe a pound and a half, and we'll put all the specs on the screen as far as the weight of the batteries and the weight of this vacuum cleaner right about now. There you go. Okay, so it has some simple instructions on keeping it clean, again, like that thing that over there. Here is the compartment that releases for the dust, which we'll put to work. So it's like a little clip right there, and that's where all the dust would come out, very much like a Dyson, if you will, if you have experience with that. On the back end, it's got a battery indicator, which is really neat. This is really cool here. It shows you the battery life, a power button, a speed up and down, and it's got a turbo mode, turbo, like your car maybe has. And if you hold it down for 3 seconds, it goes into turbo mode, which I guess is the highest and most powerful setting there. And the battery, like I said, just plugs right in. Like so. With that in there, it actually feels really good on the hand. It's got some charge in it, and that's not very loud. I'm impressed. I love it. Very convenient, very easy to use. Having the controls there makes it feel like I'm a fighter pilot or something. So very good. Moving along, another part of the wall mount assembly, I'm guessing. Let's get this out of here. We'll quickly finish the unboxing so we can actually test this thing. Let's see what else this comes with. And again, there are different models. There's the A9, there's the A9 that comes in like an affordable version. There's an ultimate one, which has a few additional attachments. And then if you go to LG's website or you visit the links below, you actually get accessory kits that you can get. So this one has this kind of like this furniture or dust attachment, has a little lint brush on there. And I think this probably like separates out to be able to attach the cleaner. So we'll play with all these settings as we use it, all these attachments. Here is a crevice tool. This is for getting in those tight spots, either between sofas or you know, in a tight spot between furniture right there. Pretty neat. Really simple. I like the color. Everything is a very modern matte gray finish. This seems to be the actual brush head that we're gonna get to here real quick, which is nice. Now, like I said, this does come with two brush heads. So one is gonna be designed for carpets and floors, so it's a combination one. And then one is the soft roller, which is specifically designed for floors only, hardwood floors. The first one that we happen to get out here is that one that I mentioned, ladder. It is the, wow, this is super soft. It's like one of those blankets you grew up with as a kid, you know, that's, it's like ultra velvety, soft to touch. And it doesn't have any bristles. If you can see, I'll hold it up at an angle for the camera. There's no bristles that exceed. It's just literally soft velvet. And this is your floor roller. So we'll test that out on some hardwood floor here in a minute. That's the head one. And then this is likely the other one. So let's check that out. Here we go. This is the combination head. This is the one you would use on carpets and or hardwood floor. Here we go. Looks exactly the same, except it has these bristles over here that run around. It doesn't have like a thousand bristles like some of the vacuum cleaners of yesteryear, in that you'll get all the hair caught in it and it's so difficult to clean it out. It just has like one simple minimalistic row of bristles that has about 2-inch separation between. So it seems like it would be a very easy maintenance item here. I'll spin that around so you could see both from the top camera and from the front. How that looks. And this is the second attachment. It's got like a little pivoting wheel here in the middle to make it easy to guide around. And again, we'll test that out when we put this to use. There's something hiding over here in the corner. Let's see what that is. I think that might be the final, yes, that is the final part of the charging base slash stand. So this is heavy, it's weighted. I would give this about a 3 or 4 pound weight. It has little rubber feet that would sit on the floor. So if you're not looking to mount this to a wall, which you don't have to, you can actually have this free stand on the floor. Because it's weighted, it's not gonna fall over or move. And that's where you'd start getting, like I said, this assembly for the actual mount, and then the vacuum cleaner would sit in front of it. So we'll put that all to use by assembling it. Let's see, make sure that we have emptied out the box. Yes, we have. There is nothing left in here. So that is the first part of this LG CordZero A9 unboxing. If you're in the market for one of these and you wanna know what comes in the box, again, the packages vary. There's some that come with extra accessories. There's some that come with less accessories. So make sure you check the link below and make sure you pick the option that best suits you. We're gonna move on to actually putting this thing to use and seeing how it works. Again, this is the first time I'm putting it to use, so you're gonna get my honest opinion as always. Before we do that, if you like this video, if you appreciate the content we're creating, if you like home tech products, if you have a home, then like this channel. Hit the subscribe button, hit the bell, get notified, hit the like button. Comment below if you're picking this up, or if you picked up a Dyson, or you picked up a Shark. Let me know what your favorite vacuum cleaner is. I might be testing a ton of these things going forward. So I look forward to seeing you here on the channel, and let's continue on with the actual test run. Hey guys, we're back. Jason Keyz here. LG CordZero here. I'm standing. It's standing. This is amazing. So here it is, out of the box, fully assembled. It's got the four attachments, two attachments, two heads, the self-standing stand because it's got a weighted base, which can also be wall mounted. And if you do so, you can have that wire cleanly tucked behind you. Maybe never ever seen it. And it's even got a slot for the second battery to charge, which I think is amazing. So simultaneously, you can charge the second battery while the vacuum is on the stand charging itself. The indicator on the front is clearly gonna show you that it's charging and what capacity the battery is charging to. The LED indicator on the side shows you that the spare battery is charging. You've got the combination floor and carpet attachment with the bristles. You've got the soft roller, which is just for hardwood floors, and you've got the crevice and the other tool over there. We're gonna put this to test. We're actually gonna throw some stuff on the floor, maybe some Cheerios, maybe some potato chips. We'll crumple it up. We will test both the combination brush and the soft roller brush, which is designed just for hardwood floors, on this hardwood floor surface. Afterwards, we'll roll out some carpet, dump a bunch of stuff on that too, and see how much it captures. So let's put it to work. All right, Roland, we have some Sun Chips, we have some Cheerios. This video is not sponsored by either of these two amazing companies, but if you see this, send me some Cheerios, send me some chips. So I'm just gonna make a disaster over here with these Cheerios. And let's open up the Sun Chips and grab a couple of those and throw them on the floor. There we go. And for the Sun Chips, we'll do something extra special. Let's actually crush them. There we go. Looks like a disaster happened in this household. We will grab the LG CordZero. Use the extension here because I'm a little taller. If you're short, you can leave it short. And this one has the combination brush, which is designed for carpet and or hardwood floors, as they claim. It's got this bristle that runs around. Super neat. Let's give it a shot. Let's try it out, see how it works. I don't think the Cheerios are doing such a great job with this vacuum cleaner. They just seem to be way too large in size. They keep getting pushed around. But the truth is, everything else seems to be being vacuumed up really well. What I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna actually stomp on these and just basically crush them up a little bit. But knowing that, so this thing is not really good at extra big particles, but let's take a look at what happens after I smash them up, and let's see if it captures everything in this little pile right here. We won't worry about the larger pieces. We'll actually pull off the nozzle and see how it handles after that. So let's give it another go. That was impressive. That really did a good job right there. So it's the larger particles that I have some concern with as far as that goes. But honestly, that's any vacuum cleaner. Let's take the brush head attachment off. So we literally are using this as a wand, if you will, literally nothing on the end. And we do have some adjustments here for the power, as in the minus and plus. And if you hold it for 3 seconds, it goes into a turbo mode, which I want to test that out real quick. There we go, all done, all gone. So definitely if you're trying to swallow up marbles with this vacuum cleaner, take off the brush head. It's gonna work a whole lot better. But it did a really good job with the combination attachment, which is really designed for carpets and floors, not just for floors. So why don't we switch to the soft attachment, which is literally like a velvet blanket, it feels like. And we're gonna do a similar test with some crushed up stuff over here. We'll do that next. And then we'll roll in the carpet and put this brush head back on and see how it does on carpet. So let's check it out. So here we have the hardwood floor attachment. This is this bare attachment, this velvety soft roller. There's no exterior, you know, protruding bristles on this guy. We're gonna snap this in over here on the vacuum cleaner. And there you go, simple as that. And that is set, that's good to go for the hardwood floor. And let's crumple up some more stuff, get some more Sun Chips this time. Let's just go with that. And we'll dump some of those on the floor. Let's crumple those up a little bit. We'll leave some a tad bit larger, a couple small pieces in there, and let's put this thing to work, see how it works with the hardwood floor attachment, see if it works any better or any worse. And here we go. Amazing. Amazing. That was perfect. I'm impressed. It's literally all gone. Cleaned the floor. Every bit of it's gone. This is great. I'm impressed. I can't tell you, like, I keep making good choices on some of these appliances that I've been picking up lately. As you can see, all the debris is clearly collected up in here in this clear chamber. I got all the Cheerios from the last round, all those Sun Chips right there, good to go. So we're gonna roll in the carpet here and put the combination brush back on, which has the bristles on it, and see how this thing performs on like a shag rug or a carpet that actually has some elevation to it, not on a bare floor. So let's move to that one next. We are back and we have carpet underneath our floor. So we've got the LG CordZero A9 back on the charging stand. It has the soft floor roller that we just used on the hardwood floor. I'm gonna swap that out. Just push a simple button here and off it comes. Super easy. I can drop it back on the stand just like that. In 1 second, it stays right there. The one-handed operation. We'll go back to our combination wood or hardwood or hard floor and carpet brush, which it comes with. And I will snap that back on here. Extend this back out. Whoops, wrong button. The extension is over here. Get that back into its longer position and we're ready to go. For this one, I decided to bring out the veggie straws again, just because they are colored and will provide a little bit of distinguishing for when we have it here on the floor. So we'll go with some of the greens and the oranges maybe, just so we can see it. There we go. I wish I had some Cheetos, but I've been eating healthy and I literally threw away half a dozen bag of Cheetos. And I know half of you out there are gonna say that's a crime. I cried a little inside when I did it, but I had to do it. So here we go. Hopefully you can see that. Let me wash my hands. All right, we've got the crushed up veggie chips on the floor. As you'll see right here, there's a power button, there is a minus button, there's a plus button. So you have a couple of different power levels. As I cycle through this quick test, I am going to press those buttons just so we can get some different levels of suction power. We're gonna start off low, of course. Here we go. All right, there we have it. We did that quick test. Let's take a closer look and see if we got it all. I'm seeing very, very little. I do see a small piece right here and right here. Now, mind you, this is not a normal carpet. This is an extremely dense, like 1-inch shaggy rug that we have over here under the dining table. So, and I only ran it over it about 3 or 4 times. So, honestly, I wanna test this on some smoother carpet like we have in the bedrooms and see how that works out. I'll put some notes in the comments below. But overall, I think this works. I'm not the biggest fan of this brush for shaggy carpets like this or something of that nature. And I also, like I said, I could have gone maybe 1 or 2 more passes since it's such a dense rug to make sure that I get everything out of there. But as you saw with the camera footage, it did its job. It picked up practically everything. And you know, I think it's gonna work perfectly on normal carpet. On the hardwood floor, I'm absolutely amazed at it. So as far as the functionality, the design of the stand, the dual batteries, everything else, I gotta give this an overall rating of about 9 out of 10. I've used Dysons, I've used Shark devices, which I love, and they're all great, but I think this one really competes well with them. This brush head is the only thing that I'm slightly concerned about, is using the combination one on hardwood floors. I wouldn't recommend it. I would bounce over to the soft one. And on a really dense rug like this, I would make sure that you either pick up larger particles and or you run it through a couple extra passes. So that's our actual functional test of the LG CordZero A9. Remember that it comes in various many packages. Some have some of the attachments, some don't. So check the link in the comments below. It'll link you to the most affordable site or wherever we found the best price on it. Plus, it'll also give you options for different categories or different packages that you can get with this vacuum cleaner. So I'm personally gonna keep this because I needed a new vacuum cleaner, and I'm also gonna keep the other device that we recently tested, which is the Shark VacMop Pro, which I'll be using in the kitchen area and anywhere that's subject to getting a ton of food around it. If you like this video, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, ring that bell if you want to see all our future videos. I appreciate you watching this. If this has helped you, drop a link in a note in the comments below and let me know if you're going to be picking it up or why you chose something different and what you chose. Maybe we'll review it next on this channel. My name is Jason Keyz. Thank you for watching. We'll see you on the next one. Tonight we're gonna die.